Welcome back to Pirate City. We're on Bill Mazeroski Field. It's a half field used for infield practice, appropriately enough. Neal Huntington, Pirate General Manager, kind enough to join us on the Pittsburgh Pulse tonight. Let's talk a little bit about A.J. Burnett, Neal. I guess in the grand scheme of things, you made a pretty good run at him, but what the Phillies threw at him just didn't really make sense here. I guess the question I have is, how hard did you think about at least qualifying him so you would have gotten a draft pick?
Yeah, the challenge is the information we had at the time we were making the qualifying offer or not. We felt like we were going to be better served as an organization to distribute that money amongst multiple players. As the offseason went on, we went and signed a starting pitcher with the intent that A.J. was not coming back. A.J. really didn't impact what we did this offseason, didn't hinder us, didn't limit us in any way. And as we engaged in conversations with him again in January, if he had come back to us, he would have made us that much better. The money that wasn't necessarily there for the qualifying offer, we hadn't find the right guys to spend it on, and we're able to commit a few more dollars than maybe we were anticipating toward A.J. In our minds, he had an opportunity to pitch close enough to home that he can be home at any given time. He's got a chance to compete. Philadelphia's going to have a good club this year, and so it met both of his criteria. He would have loved to have come back, but as A.J. talked about, this was for his family, and he wants to compete another year, but this was a compromise, and he was able to do it closer to home.
You know, A.J.'s leadership was the one part that a lot of Pirate fans have pointed to. I don't think that there's a lack of that behind him in the locker room, especially with guys like McCutchen and Hurdle doing the things that they do. But is there an edge that he brought to the team that you'll have to find another guy who can maybe replicate that?
A.J. did a lot of good things for us on and off the field, and we'll never be able to say that he didn't, because he absolutely did. At the same time, he helped some people grow up, and he helped some guys mature, and he helped some guys take that next step in their career. Francisco Liriano is a different type of leader. He leads by example. That's the type of leader Andrew is. We've got some guys that are maturing. Charlie Morton's maturing. We get Juani Rodriguez healthy again. We've got some guys that are ready to step up and fill those big shoes that A.J. carried for us. There's no question he helped us take a big step forward as an organization, and he's going to help us sustain that.
Well, when you press forward now, is there a possibility, if things don't work out at first base or right field over the next 5 weeks, that you could still make a move by opening day?
Oh, we absolutely always look to see if there's something that makes us better. The challenge is, how much is it? What does it cost you in terms of prospects? Prospects are as valuable as they've ever been as you start to look at what some non-regular position players are getting in free agency. We're going to have to continue to be creative and produce our own players, not only everyday guys and impact guys, but some of the extras as well. But we'll look to see if there's the right spot out there to make us better. At the same time, we'll have a chance to see what these guys are up to this spring, but we never stop trying to get better.
The energy at the ballpark this year, every year it seems to been growing. You got closer, closer, closer. Then you guys won the wild card last year. What are you expecting from the fans' perspective, that the turnstiles coming through and the support that they'll be giving this year?
Well, we've raised the bar of their expectation level, and we've certainly gone from hoping to be 500 to expecting to win, and now our goal doesn't change. Our goals never change. It's to win a World Series, and once we do that, wake up the next day and figure out and work really hard to defend that. That's never changed for us, so our approach really isn't any different than it's ever been. The fans, can't thank them enough for the support we felt last year. That wild card game was like no experience, no environment I've ever experienced, and then they did it again against the two games versus St. Louis. So they've raised the bar, and we're looking forward to them coming out again. As we talked about the day we got here, we were looking forward to giving them a team that they'd feel proud for, that they'd come out and cheer for, and they did it, and now we've got to keep winning games for them and keep putting a team on the field that they're proud of.
Well, best of luck to you this year, and we appreciate you taking time out to talk to us today.
Guy, Justin, thanks so much.
Thanks so much.
All right, Neal Huntington, Pirate General Manager. Don't go anywhere. More from spring training coming up on Channel 4 Action News.